Hi friends, I hope you have started uploading your images in stock agencies, but some of you might have faced this issue where your images are rejected due to presence of clearly visible brand names and logos. Well, there's absolutely nothing to worry. Today I will show you the ways that I do to avoid such issues. Let's get started. Just as a reminder, do subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon for the notification so that you can get the videos exactly the moment I bring them out. To avoid this issue, I use Adobe Photoshop. Photoshop has a large number of tools that can help you get the job done very easily. Well, I'm not a veteran and these are not the only ways, but these are the ways that I prefer to do the job. So let's head straight to Photoshop.
So here's the first image. It's an image with a good stock value. It can be used as a holiday image. Over here, two ladies are holding hand. Well, I need to zoom it into full resolution of 100% to see if there is any logo, right? And there is a Wildcraft logo. Now, if I submit the image just like this into stock agency, it will surely be rejected. Now, the first and foremost thing I need to do is make a duplicate layer by dragging this layer over that area. You can also do it by pressing Ctrl J or Command J in Photoshop. Thereafter, we need to select the lasso tool, which is L key, and make a selection beside the logo as close as possible. So now the logo being selected, we will hit edit, fill, and select content aware from the drop down list and content and click OK. Boom! You see, the logo is gone, just like that. You can see it was there and now it's gone. Now this image is perfect for uploading into the stock website. Well, there is another way. Let me delete this layer and show you another tool with which you can remove this logo. We will make a duplicate layer and now we will use the clone stamp tool. We select the clone stamp tool with the short key S. Now clone stamp tool does what? Clone stamp tool picks an area from the surroundings and uses artificial intelligence to mimic the pixels. It will mimic the pixels from the surrounding areas and we can paint those pixels into the affected area. So let's select quickly and start painting very carefully. We are painting these areas with slow strokes. You see, the graphic tablet really works best with clone stamp tool. You can do this with mouse also, but tablet is the best because I have set my brush to pen pressure. Keep painting the areas. Occasionally we need to select the source points. We can't do it via the fixed point. It varies from region to region. You need to play around to know which area you need to select it from, but it will give you the best results. So we are almost done here. Just a few left and we are done. It looks so original, as if there was never any logo. We can undo the layer to see as if we have used an eraser, right? Now the next image I click while being in bus. Before uploading, I found there was a logo, right? We can see a Volvo logo clearly. Now to remove this, first we'll make a background layer. Thereafter, we will select the lasso tool, as I said, with L key. After selecting the lasso tool, we will draw, we'll select the area surrounding the logo as close as possible. So now we have made the selection, we will hit edit, fill, and content aware. Now you see, Content Aware uses an artificial intelligence to mimic the pixels from the surrounding areas. So it has created a ridge, right, out of nowhere. So we need to get rid of this also. So we will select closely around this and again hit edit, fill Content Aware. Right, we can deselect it with Control D. Now we see it's more or less done. It has done a very good job actually. However, you know, I am a perfectionist and I am a pixel peeper. So I would like to get rid of the smudges, right? So I select the clone stamp tool to mimic the pixels from the surrounding region. And I will paint it over the smudges, which appears not that much perfect to me. It's almost as good as finished, but with a bit of touch up with clone stamp tool, it's more or less done. You can play around to see what suits you. If you are pleased with the finished result, even without using the clone stamp tool, you are free to do so. Right, so here it is done. The Volvo logo is gone. It's magic, right? Now the next image, let's first make a duplicate layer. This is a travel image and it has been sold many times, the final version of this image, right? But in the original image, if we zoom to the full resolution, we see there is a logo on the cable car, right? So definitely it will be rejected by the stock agencies and we need to get rid of this before submitting. So over here I will show you all the three ways that I can do this. If you are in absolute hurry, you can simply use the paint tool. You can select the brush using B and drop on the area, clicking Alt and simply paint the area, right? It won't give you the best results, but it will do the job. Well, the next and my most favorite method, easy method of doing, is by Content Aware fill tool. We will select the lasso tool and select the region to edit, fill and Content Aware. Similarly, I will also hit edit, fill, Content Aware. Right, and lastly it can also be done by clone stamp tool. We will need to select the areas around and we will simply use paint the area from the pixel from the surrounding area. You see, clone stamp tool doesn't always do the best job on the first try, but if you select another area and do the perfect finish according as your eye suits, you will get the best result. You see, the logo is gone.
So friends, I hope now you have a brief idea about how to get rid of those brand names and logos from your stock images, right? Let me know in the comment section if you want me to cover all these tools in details, because there's much more to these tools than what I just told you in this short video. Without further delay, start working on your images that have been rejected due to brand names and logos, get rid of everything and then re-upload them into the stock agencies, and I hope they will be accepted. Do subscribe to this channel because I will be bringing at least one video every week to cover the details about various photography tutorials as well as how to sell your images online via stock photography. Bye!